always forget to do this at the start of videos. We film these reactions live, like I'm doing right now. So if you ever see that I'm live recording, you should come stop in. I interact with the chat. I get people's thoughts on the album. I even include some chats in the videos if I think they are particularly insightful or interesting. And yeah, I am just going to get straight into this album. Track one, title track. I've already heard this song, Symbolic. The best highlight of Death's unconventional song structure in this song. I've heard it a lot. I've listened to this song a lot of times, and it kind of just like gets better every time I hear it. It is just more. I just pick up on more things. I notice like extra details. I feel like just the insane energy of this song is like unmatched by like anything else I've heard in this genre. This song is so good. The two ride cymbals is so cool. Oh my god. God, the switch-ups all work so well. Sounds like Chester Bennington? I mean, not really. I don't even mind the fade out that much. It's not great, but I don't mind it. Listen, I've heard that song before, and every single time I listen to it, it grows on me. I just notice extra details. I just feel like this song clicks with me even stronger every single time I return to it. That is honestly one of the best openers to a metal album ever. That is, like, about as perfect as, like, you can get with death metal, with technical death metal. There's even like elements of like some like proggy stuff in there. This is about as good as it gets in this genre. I don't really see how any other song on this album or any other song in this subgenre of metal could top it. That song is a 10. Probably my favorite death song that I've heard. Like, absolutely. It's like the definition of perfection. It's so good. Death over Metallica? I agree. Metallica, they have three great albums. They have Ride the Lightning, they have Master of Puppets, and they have the Black Album. I haven't heard all of their other albums, but I've heard, I think, at least one song from each of their other albums. And then there's like some of the full albums I've heard, like their last one. And none of them have been great. Like, their last album was fine, but I've not really enjoyed much stuff from any of their other albums that I've heard. So, yeah. And everything I've heard from Death, I've thought, has been incredible. So, yeah, I definitely agree. Next track, we have Zero Tolerance. Hello? Okay, it's just not playing anything. Hold on a sec. There we go. I've not heard this one yet. The speeding up and slowing down is so cool. The recording of the drums is so good. They are so thick and so heavy and so loud. I love the way the drums are recorded and the cymbals too. It's one of the best drum sounds in like any metal album. It's incredible. Yeah, that song was incredible. Where the previous song felt like it was constantly building, this song feels like it's constantly descending. And it like doesn't let up. It doesn't have a single moment where I feel like the energy is too low. It's definitely slower than the previous song, but I feel like it still keeps up like that same level of intensity and energy. Listen, I am very sick right now, so I am not able to properly form my thoughts. this song was incredible, and I think it was nearly as good as the first song. I give it like a 9.8. That was so good. That was actually incredible. This dude sounds like Surge from your suggestion. This guy sounds nothing like Surge Tankian. Next track, we have Empty Words. Is it gonna play? Whoa. The echoey vocals are so cool. Surprising amount of lyrical depth for a death metal album. Like, a genuinely, like, a shocking amount of, like, lyrical competency. Normally, like, the writing is sort of just, like, throwaway for the sound. The writing's actually pretty incredible here. Yeah, I think the writing is incredible here. They're able to take lyrical themes that are so simple and personal, like struggling to move on from something, and make it sound like this big, grand, like, end of the world sounding song. Like, straight up, had I not, like, actually sat here and focused on the lyrics, I would just assume he's talking about, like, the devil rising up from hell or something, as most death metal bands do. But no, there is, like, actual powerful writing here, and it's so cool. Okay, I like this fade out, actually. Surprisingly, like, I think this is a great fade out. That was never in Guitar Hero, really. This sounds like it would be perfect for Guitar Hero. No, listen, firstly, I'm not crying. My eyes are watering because, you know, that thing where, like, you got a runny nose and then, like, unblocks a little bit and your eyes start watering? That is what just happened to me, and it doesn't feel great. That song is a 10. Yes, that song is fantastic. Oh, I'm getting a spam call. Anyway, as I was saying, yeah, that song is a 10. That was better than what I was even expecting from this album. Like, hearing Symbolic, that song, I still think Symbolic is my favorite death song I've heard.
Hello, how's it going? It says no free, wait, was there no free request? Hold on. Oops, I didn't mean to have that on. How's it going? Hello. We got Crocky, Addy, David. How's it going, everybody? We're open to suggestions. If anyone, like, has a suggestion that I find, like, particularly interesting, that I'm like, oh yeah, that'll be really good, then I'll add it. But for the most part, no. I mean, you can submit a suggestion if you want, but it's not guaranteed they'll make it on to the wheel. A tornado almost hit a nuclear power plant today. That doesn't sound very good. Chat. Right before I came up here, you know, during that starting soon screen, I quickly went downstairs. I was gonna get myself a drink, and my dog decided when I went downstairs, you know what, I am going to piss just right up against the cat's litter box, which is just so helpful of my dog to do. It's like, why? It wasn't that long ago that you were outside. You can have to piss again. Why? But no, he did. So I've just had to clean that up, which is just so fun. Based dog? No, not based dog. L dog. I do. I have a dog and I have two cats. You can see a dot. Hold on a sec. I'll get up the short with my dog in it. Five worst albums I've listened to? I couldn't even tell you. There's a lot of bad albums I've listened to. My dog is a Sigma and I'm a Beta. Exactly. My dog's in one of my shorts. Let me find it. I forget which one it is. It's in, like, one of the shitty shorts I used to make, where I was like, Oh, this video is out now. You guys should go watch it. Oh, it's in this one. It's in the Amnesiac Part 1. Is the Strokes on there? Yes. He's in this short, I think. There he is. There's my doggy. That's Milo. Look at him. I do love that dog. He's a bit of an asshole sometimes, but I do love him. He's the best. And also, he's in the Amnesiac video. Because I remember he like started barking and I had to go downstairs and try and like see what was up with him, try and calm him down, and then someone in the chat said, "Bro went to beat his dog." I was like, "No, I didn't." And he was like, "Prove it then," and I brought Milo up. He was on screen for a sec. Add penis to the wheel? No. Anyway, let's figure out our first suggestion, our first album of the day. Wildlife. Okay. I don't know what this is, but our first album is Wildlife. Why the fuck is the free queue stuff up here? Get that off. No. Oh no, we want that. Don't want that. And we don't want that. There we go. Oxygen indeed. This was from when I filmed my Swans short last night. The way I do it is I just like literally record my Spotify audio. David Attenborough album, real. Carbon dioxide over oxygen, true. Searched up Lizzo for my freaking the short I made because I was like, huh. Her first album did come out in 2014, so I went to check it to see what the album was. And it's like, no one's listened to this shit. I remember I only know it because I looked up Lizzo on Album of the Year to see like what people's general thoughts on her album was, because I was considering listening to one of our albums. And I was like, then I saw she released something in 2014, and I hadn't heard of her until like 2021. Wildlife is our first album. Oh, it's the La Dispute. Oh, okay. I've heard two songs off of this album. This song. Wait, which one was the King Park is great. You and I in Unison is also pretty good. Day 7 waiting for haircut. It's coming. It's coming. Body shames our dancers. Yeah. Lizzo is in hot water right now. She put out that thing saying she quit music because like of the stuff that was like came out about her. And then she apparently in like another video she made, she was like, "I'm not quitting, guys. I'm not quitting." Something like that. Yeah, people don't like Lizzo very much right now. One subgenre is poetry on Album of the Year. Yeah. Sharp myself? I'm good. Screamo poetry, huh? Oh shit, this is listed as poetry. Look at this. It literally, they have it listed as emo, post-hardcore, screamo, and poetry. Huh. Okay. It's like the game Fantano does. Exactly. Where he gets people to come on and figure out which genre is real. It's just like To Pimp a Butterfly. Exactly. A Departure is the first song. Can't wait for Fantano to invite me to the show. Surely it'll have to happen sometime soon. I mean, 700 subscribers. I mean, I'm the real deal. What can I say? That album cover looks like the peanut butter baby. What are you talking about? The peanut butter? You mean the baby that goes, ah? It's like, does that feel good? Ah. You talking about that baby? Oh, the Swans album. Yeah, you think this is the peanut butter baby? Yeah? Yep. He reviewed the Ken Carson album, and in response, a Ken Carson fan fucking leaked his divorce papers, which is wild. That is the craziest thing to do. Thankfully, I'm only 17, so I haven't experienced a divorce yet, so if I ever give that Ken Carson album a bad rating, they can't really leak that. Yep. Cap? Yeah. What can I say? I've already... They could maybe leak that guy I killed back in 1983, but besides that, there's not really anything, any dirt anyone has on me. Now you know I say poetry, yeah? Listen, chat. I'm not gonna lie to you, the thought of getting a buzz cut is becoming more and more tempting. I was watching Tom Scar video. My hair grows really fast. And he said, if you have the privilege of having hair that can grow back really quick, you may as well do cool stuff with it. And I was like, shit, that's correct. So I'm thinking about maybe, possibly, actually getting a buzz cut, and you will see me with no hair. If Fantano made an OnlyFans, you would buy it in a heartbeat. Wow. What do you guys think? Get rid of all of it? Because I could. Buzz cut the song is a ten. I'm not talking about the song. I'm talking about... Do you think I would look like a complete moron without any hair? Or more of a moron than I do now? That was a pretty great opener, I can't lie. It looks really good as of now. You would have done maybe red highlights. Would be Sid from Toy Story. You're not wrong. Pretty incredible transition there. Track one is getting an 8.5 from me. That was a pretty solid opener. Yeah, that sort of just had all of the elements I've really enjoyed from the other two songs I've heard from the album. I think that the... really wild, manic vocals sound great. The production is fantastic. It's a great tone setter. I feel like the writing in spots is a little like, okay, but for the most part, it's pretty good. Yeah, it was a pretty great opener. 8.5. Harder harmonies. No, not Sid, please. My face shape isn't the same as Sid from Toy Story. He's sort of got like a wider jaw than I do. Sid, Toy Story. Yeah, his jaw kind of like goes out at the bottom and then comes in. Mine is just... Yeah, my face isn't wide enough. I don't have green eyes. And my forehead isn't... Well, my forehead's pretty big, but isn't that big. So I wouldn't be Sid from Toy Story. No, not Sid the Sloth. The drive, but more poetic. I almost read that as pathetic, but. Also pathetic, yeah. Try to survive 5 seconds in Slough Challenge, impossible. That's so true. In a relatable way, you mean no insult, you really like this? I mean, you're not wrong. Really great halftime. You don't like his voice? That's fair. Huh? Gonna transition again? Huh. Okay. Listen, the tag was not lying on Album of the Year. This is definitely emo. However, it's likable emo, which is not something I can say about a lot of things. This is genuinely, like, fun. And... despite how melodramatic and over the top it is, it doesn't feel like it's pushing it too far. It's like 21 Pilots if they were more emo and rock. Huh? Now, 21 Pilots stick way too close to the pop formula. This is definitely a little more, like, off and a little more, like, I don't know. There's something very Fantano core about this, if that makes sense. As long as it's about being a musician. Yeah, but the way it's presented is in the most overdramatic, freaking emo music type way possible, but it's still likable. It's still fun. And I don't know. There's something about it. This is just putting a grin on my face. 8.7. Oh, chat, speaking of 21 Pilots, oh my god, the album's coming out soon. When is the album coming out? I wasn't raised in the hood, but I know a thing or two about Pain and Darkness. Exactly. Having all of these songs hearted is a crime. This song's terrible. Okay? No. 36 Days. Okay, first two singles off of this album, bangers. First two singles off of this album, very good. Okay? I'm very excited. Mind you, that one Bring Me the Horizon song. What, Can You Feel My Heart? Or something like this? Something like that? Or is it Can You Feel the Dark? I have these thoughts so often, like, yeah, wow. Damn. Recording of this is great. Yeah, Travis. This is what the edge of your seat was made for. I've never listened to it. That's really cool. The actual drums are panned to the left, and then you're just hearing like an echo of them in the right channel. The guitar is very good. By the way, for my 1000 sub special, I'm thinking of doing Swan's Worst to Best video. I feel like that'd be a good video to do for 1k subs, because I kind of don't shut up about Swans. The mixing is in fact very good. Sounds incredible. Viper version of Soundtracks for the Blind. I didn't even know that existed. All of these transitions are really interesting. These transitions are really cool. Yeah. 9 out of 10. I'm feeling like about the same as like a flat 9 for me. That was... What's the best cover song ever? I don't know. There's some pretty great covers out there, but I don't know what the best one would be. Yeah. Every single song up to this album... On this album, up to this point, has been fantastic. Like, this thing... None of it has really, like... Felt like it's gone too far into emo territory. None of it's felt like it's... None of it's felt like it's... Like, too over the top or anything like that. I'm doing a great job at talking today, if you couldn't tell. I don't know, there's just something so likable and so, like, actually real about this that it doesn't just feel like wow, wow, wow emo music, you know what I'm saying? Despite the fact that it's still pretty emo regardless. I actually like this a lot. I'm liking this a lot so far. Yeah, that song gets a 9. Madcon begging, and there's no question about it. There's a huge tornado near you. That is not good. You might want to be not near the huge tornado. Next track, edit your hometown. Oh, it's 30 minutes away. You'll be fine. See, the thing, we don't get tornadoes here, so I don't know if being 30 minutes away from a tornado actually means you're, like, far away from it or not. But 30 minutes away, I guess that's decently far. That's close. Damn. Royal blood scream zesty to you? Huh? What do you mean royal blood scream zesty to you? They just are? Wow. Wink core? Wow. Yeah. Car seat headrest is also twink core. Car seat headrest is 100% twink core. Huh? Guitars. Travis County, try not to say the most out-of-pocket shit, but exactly. Listen, even, like, this song, which is probably, like, the least impressive song for me so far, it still goes, like, crazy hard. I give that one, like, an 8.3. Yeah. Every single song on this album has just been fantastic. The vocals on this one in particular, I thought, were very strong. The vocals on this one went crazy. How's it going, Ryan K? Twinkcore stands for high feminine vocals mixed with post-hardcore. No, I refuse. Car Seat Headrest is still Twinkcore, okay? Simply due to the lyrics and the fact that Will Toledo is the front man of Car Seat Headrest, okay? Royal Blood cover of Sad But True is one of the zestiest and worst rock songs you've heard. Alright. This album's 14 songs. It's going crazy so far. Oh yeah, chat, before I get into this next song, I need to inform you all of something, bro. Last night, listen, this doesn't like matter about anything, right? I just want to share this. Last night, I like went to bed at 12. It only took me an hour to fall asleep, right? I went to bed at 1 a.m. I fell asleep at 1 a.m. And I woke up at 12 p.m. today. I got 11 hours of unbroken sleep. 11 hours. That has not happened to me in, like, in years. That is the most sleep I've gotten in a single night in years. I got 11 hours. I don't know if I've ever slept that long, honestly. It was crazy. Because I woke up, I looked down at my phone, I was like, I fell asleep at 1 a.m. Why is it 12? It was ridiculous. Weezer Enter Sandman. That sounds like the pinnacle of music. G-Eazy Lateralis? There's no way that's a thing. G-Eazy Lateralis? Hold on. I refuse to believe that's a thing. Oh, it's Lazarus. G-Eazy covering Tool, that would be crazy. There's no way. Look up here, I'm in heaven. I've got scars I can't see. No way. What? Huh? There is no- Oh my god. Why have I changed this to a wheel stream? I don't know. I just wanted to do a wheel stream. Took an extremely personal David Bowie song and made it about himself. Yeah, David Bowie wrote a song about the fact that he was literally about to die. And then G-Eazy was like, I can do it better. Wow. That, wow.
Stories, but the letters in between, and I guess that's why it haunts the pages of every
I actually love the rating. Of self-awareness. Yeah. Do I feel embarrassed about it? I think you know the answer. Bass sounds incredible. I think you probably feel a little bit embarrassed for me. But you, I know I should have moved on ages ago. Michael Jira is still asking to bring the sun. Yeah. 9 years late, 10 years later. It's 2024, not 2023. That was one of my favorites up to this point. Gonna let it transition. Oh no, no transition out of that one. Yeah, that was one of my favorites so far. It's one of the most low-key songs so far. It didn't have like a particular like explosive moment. It just kept building and building and building, and then sort of like, I guess, calming back down. Which I actually kind of like that. I like that it didn't go for an explosive moment. It showed more restraint. It made for something actually pretty unique and different. And I think it worked pretty well. Yeah, that was one of my favorites up to this point. 8.8. The sound's going crazy right now. The sound's actually surprisingly great. I mean, I liked the two songs that I've been sent in. I think King Park was incredible. And You and I in Unison was also pretty great. But I wasn't expecting to think the whole album was going to be this great. Next track, Safer in the Forest / Love Song for Paul Michigan. Second highest on Album of the Year. This has a 94. And King Park has a 98, obviously. Are there any songs with a 100 score on Album of the Year? I've been watching a slow thaw come around. I've been waiting in the cold, hazy blue. I've been driving alone out to the edge of town. I've been thinking too much of you. OT Genesis never knew. Penith or Total Zanarchy, which is better? No. Never Knew does not have a 100, it has a 93. You're lying to me. These drums sound incredible.
I've been thinking too much of you. Settled in that
kind of sound like Radiohead. The guitar's a little bit. I'm guessing that was the transition into Love Song for Poor Michigan. I do one specific song, you have your fingers on it. Why does the chat keep stopping and starting? Like up here. Yeah, that was two songs stuck into one. And I think that they worked together perfectly. The transition between the two was fantastic. I feel like going from the, I guess, more low-key, subtle, Safer in the Forest, straight into the burst of energy that was Love Song for Poor Michigan was great. I feel like the two tracks like worked perfectly together. Yeah, that might have been my favorite so far. 9.3. Sounds great so far. This is working really well. The Most Beautiful Bit of Fruit up next. Remember when Lil Xan OD'd on Cheetos? What? Threw a chair off the sixth-story roof of a popular bar in Nashville and is now arrested. Morgan Wallen? Damn. Damn. Quite literally. Quite literally. Didn't he say the N-word openly? I honestly don't know. I don't know much about Morgan Wallen, I can't lie. Yeah, the thing that makes this album so far has been the dynamics. Well, great drop indeed. The dynamics, and the sense of timing, have been perfect. The transitions from the super subtle moments into like the insane explosive moments have been actually perfect. Like, this is blowing me away as it's going along. That was fantastic. That was like another flat nine for me. Yeah, that from the writing to the performances, everything is just tight as hell. The production too, and the mixing is fantastic. This is like the best emo music ever. Next track, A Poem. There's a video of him throwing the chair. It was on a traffic cam. Oh my god. Imagine getting caught on a traffic cam. Throwing a chair off a building. That's crazy. Man, this album is surprisingly creative. Like, based on the two songs I heard, I wouldn't expect this much, like, variety out of it. This is actually surprisingly very creative. They're trying a bunch of different things here, and, like, all of them are working so far. Yeah, that... Oh, my God, we got King Park up next as well. That was great. That was actually great. That was... What? Was that the shortest song so far? Second shortest song so far. This one's 2 minutes and 55. It didn't, like, blow me away or anything, but I'm just surprised at how, like, creative and fun this is. This is working, like, really well. You need to do your maths homework. That is unfortunate. That is unfortunate. You know, I don't have school for another 5 days. I don't have to go back into college for another 5 days. So I'm kind of chilling. But yeah, when I do go back, I will be very unhappy. I'm making the most of the time that I don't have to be in there. Next 98 on album of the year? Nah. Too many 8 out of 10s. It can't get a 98. Mathematically speaking. King Park up next. This is the song I gave a 10, I think. It is. Well, score spoiled. Score spoiled. Oh, yeah, okay. I remember why I gave this a 10. It's pretty effective so far. I've not re-listened to this song since I was sent it in. It's about as good as I remember it being. Yeah, this song literally feels like just an immediate response to, like, I guess that's what this is. I'm pretty sure that's what I remember think it was AD who sent this in. I think this is what he said. This is like an immediate response to like a shooting that happened, and it's just someone just angrily shouting about it. Like, just it's an immediate response of just pure anger, and it works so well. It's so effective and like impactful. Man, this is actually hitting. This is going like, I'm liking this more than the first time I listened to it somehow. It's insane how accurate the lyrics are to real life. I think this is like the lead singer's like response to like an actual shooting that happened. Let me get this up on Genius. One of Utter Spute's most popular songs, it derives its name from the Martin Luther King Park in the Grand Rapids, MI, the band's hometown. The song depicts a real event that took place there. A guy wanted to kill his rival, but the shot was misfired and hit an innocent kid instead. The killer flees and shuts himself in a hotel room, in the end persecuted by the police. He commits suicide. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Damn. That is insane. Average day in America. Calmest day in Slough, to be honest. Safest day in Birmingham. You're not wrong, Eddie. That does sound like something someone would say. Jesus Christ. Can I still get into heaven if I kill myself? Can I ever be forgiven? Cause I killed that kid. It was an accident, I swear it wasn't meant for him. And if I turn it on me, if I even it out, can I still get in? Or will they send me to hell? Can I still get into heaven if I kill myself? I left the hotel behind. Man, yeah. I completely forgot about that ending. Jesus Christ. Yeah, that is like the most blunt, horrific way to end that. Oh my God. And the fact that it's based on true events as well is so awful. Yeah. Giving that song, saying, oh, this song is a 10 out of 10. There's something about that feels wrong. But I feel like just the way this is put across, the incredible, like, storytelling here, the way they are able to so vividly portray what happened, as well as having an instrumental that feels like it fits perfectly, it doesn't feel like they take too long to get it across with like the nearly 7 minute runtime. Giving it a 10 feels wrong, but that's genuinely what I feel on that song. That is, wow. I'm just gonna move on. That was pretty amazing. Yeah, I am just gonna move on. Next track, Edward Bends 27 Times. Literally does anything right. You don't see a reason why not to give it a 10 out of 10 unless you want into it, exactly. But giving it a score just feels a bit like... Okay. I'm actually going to look at Genius for some more of these songs. Another song based on a real event. According to Jordan, Edward Benz had a schizophrenic son who took pills to keep his illness under control. One day he decided to stop taking the pills and went mad, shutting himself in his house. His father came, and when he opened with the door key, his son assaulted him with a knife, killing him. Maybe 27 times is the number of times his son stabbed him. What, did this happen in, like, the same place where they grew up? Damn. You just got a tech. Oh my god, bro. You shouldn't be telling me about this. I can't help you with that, Travis. That's not good, but I can't really help. Average day in Maidstone? This is the safest day in Blackpool, to be honest. Safest day in Blackpool. What is it you thought you'd find? Yeah, Addy. You just think it's weird. That is... Damn. I live in a city of 2 million people and wonder if everyone got it. Oh, people in like your area probably got it. It's like the Nickelback music video where random college students got on alarm for Nickelback show. Wow. Oh,
I would honestly rather get, like, an emergency alert than know that Nickelback are playing near me, to be honest.
Yeah, that was Jalapeno, I agree. Yeah, I agree. I love the vocals here. Gonna transition? But on the dance floor, did a music video of a school shooting called Rise and Shine with Martin Luther King leading up to a dubstep breakdown? Oh my god. With Martin Luther King leading up to a dubstep breakdown. That is crazy. That song was just as good as the previous one, to be honest. Yeah, the storytelling on both of these songs is just so vivid and just so blunt. And it's effective as hell, man. That is... That's fucked. That is... Ugh. Man. Yank crime? Drive like Jehu? What is that? Yank crime... What is this? I've never heard of this. Possibly. Really cool math rock album. I'll think about it. I've got too many albums on the freaking wheel right now, though. I don't want to add any more. I've got, how do I see how many? I've got 41 albums on the list right now. I don't want to add too many more. I don't add any more right now, actually. I see everything up next.
Part celebration song, her warmth and smile.
song presents an interesting feature because it's the first one by La Dispute told in the form of a diary. The protagonist is in high school, 2004-ish, and one day his teacher starts the lesson by reading some pages from a diary she kept many years before, in 1980, about her little son who lost his battle against cancer. Oh my god. Man, this album's it's just so fucked going into the back half. I probably should have, like, looked at the lyrics on Genius for the first half of the album as well. Who let blood on the dance floor cook? The music video is beyond cringe. I haven't seen it. Oh man, oh that's horrible. Oh my god. Yeah, Addy. Man, that is... That is horrible. Wow. Yeah, the fact that these songs are, like, based on real events and how just vivid and blunt and they just get straight to the point. No sugarcoating, just... Man. How's it going, Fire? You don't like emo, but this is incredible? Yeah. Listen, that is the closest I have ever been to breaking down into tears on stream. That was...
That was actually horrible. That was... Man... Fuck this album for being so well written. Man. Next track, A Broken Jar. I just read the next track. This track doesn't have any description on Genius, so I'm actually going to have to follow along with the lyric annotations. Wait, is this a concept album? I looked at the first lyric annotation and it says, the main character's fourth and final letter in the album as he continues to try and understand the longevity of his misery and his inability to move past it. This is a concept album, and I've just been missing out on the story. Huh. Okay. I'll probably have to listen to this. Well, I'm going to listen to this again. But I'll have to like look at the lyrics on Genius, figure out the story. I think Paul is dead in Godzilla. Just in time for the tears. Trying to summon AD, just typing metalcore. Yeah. What is that gif? Fuck you, play Wise Now? Joanna Newsom album? That's such a specific gif. Why does that exist? Woke up just a few minutes ago? Damn. Yeah, I woke up at 12 o'clock today. I got 11 hours of sleep last night. Bear in mind, most of the time I get like 2 or 3 hours of sleep, so 11 hours is crazy for me. The job early just to show up to the saddest stream. I wouldn't say the stream itself is sad, it's just the music is very, very depressing and very real, and this hurts a little bit to listen to. This is probably my least favorite song so far, by the way. It's like a flat 8. It's just the least impressive and the least memorable. It's still like incredibly well recorded, produced, the vocals are still really good. It's like a letter from this main character or something. The lyrics are actually fairly interesting. It's just the least interesting so far. Still a flat 8. Still very good. 7 out of 10, too short. Actually, you're kind of right. I think I'm going to move this down to like a high 7, like a 7.7. You're actually, yeah, 7.7 sounds, well, high 7, I guess, sounds more accurate to what I feel about that song. All our bruised bodies and the whole heart shrinks. Huh. Okay. See what Genius has to say about this one. Absolutely nothing. All right. So now, tell me how your story goes. Have you ever listened to Tazwell after I mentioned it? Bro, Tazwell. Bro, that song hurts me to listen to. Exactly, yeah. It's for like 8 minutes long and it's like the best thing in the entire Minecraft soundtrack. I can't listen to it.
Have you had a moment forced the whole heart
Looks like he's talking about losing empathy. I guess after all of the talking about like the real life's like situations that have occurred, this song seems to be him talking about like, yeah, he's saying like, have you had a moment force the whole heart to grow or retract or just shrink? Does the heart shrink? Were you told as a child how cruel the whole world could be? Did anybody tell you that? He seems to be literally just losing all empathy at this point. It's pretty fucked. You cannot stand his voice? That is fair. Crocky said he didn't like this guy's voice either. I could see that. I love the vocals on this. But yeah, I could see why he wouldn't like the voice. Most depressing album I've listened to? I've listened to a lot of very depressing albums. A Crow Looked at Me is up there. Lazarus by David Bowie is up there. I don't know, I've listened to a lot of sad albums. Probably A Crow Looked at Me, though. A Crow Looked at Me is... Oh, man. Incredible album, but a terrible listen. It's so sad. Mira Asher. Not familiar with that. Fantana gave this album a strong 8. Oh, you're not wrong. Sam's not for you, 6 out of 10 overall. That's fair. Okay, so I've not been paying attention to the story, but this is sort of bringing everything together, I guess. Color Revolt. I'm probably just gonna get around to that anyway, so I'm probably not gonna add this to the wheel. Lyric sign updating. There we go. It's because I was looking at Genius. Yeah, it doesn't update when I look at Genius. You like everything but the singer's voice. You wish you could like it. That's fair. Back in your day, there was no Genius. It's like comforting the listener after witnessing all the horror he spouted. Yeah. You had the CD lyric book? Definitely get the emotional appeal. You just tend to look at the instrumental first and it's not anything attention grabbing. That's fair. I'm not adding penis to the album wheel. This Genius guy knows a lot about music. Yeah, he does. Immaculate transition into You and I in unison. Another great track. Not one of my favorites up to this point, but actually, I'll give it like a flat 9. Yeah, it's not like my absolute favorite up to this point, but it did a great job of tying together a bunch of the lyrical themes and a bunch of the stories that had occurred so far and how it's affected this guy mentally.
I just, the reason it doesn't get a higher score is just because, like, it isn't the most emotionally impactful song we've had up to this point, and it's probably not one I would return to. I don't feel like I would really return, like, consistently to a lot of the stuff on the back half of this album, to be honest. It's kind of just, like, emotional torture in the form of an album for the back half. And I'm pretty sure if I actually, like, look into the lyrics and figure out the concept of the first half, I imagine it will be the same for me with that. This is definitely going to reward a second listen, I think. Final track, You and I in Unison. I have heard this song. I've been sending it in on stream before, and I think I've returned to this one a couple of times since I heard it. Yeah, it starts off with saying, what will I find? Yeah. Why is Penith not on there? I will show you guys why Penith isn't on there. How about that? You guys, I will show you all why Penith has not made the wheel of albums. Let's sort by lowest rated here. This right here is why Penith did not get on there. What the fuck? Why did? Okay. What the hell? 58 critic score. Why? 66 and 50? Huh? Packs a lyrical punch, but wanes replay value. I don't think he wants to be taken seriously, though. According to the lyrics of that album, he is very upset that he doesn't get taken seriously. All music is invalid. Yeah, they give out some goofy scores, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, like what you like, I guess, but like 50 on Penith? Really? The album of the millennia. Yeah, nothing in the next, nothing until the year 3000 will live up to Penith. I'm getting distracted by my ring light. Yeah, we're gonna listen to a couple albums this stream. You have Trauma from Jail Song Part 1. Name is Lil Dicky, of course you can't take him seriously. Yeah. But then that entire album, like, some of the songs are like, man, I want people to start taking me seriously. I want to actually transition into being a respectful artist because I'm just the punching bag of jokes to people. And then he has a song like Jail Song on that album. And it's like, pick a lane, man. Pick a lane. You meant to take you seriously or not? System of a Down did it better. Yeah, System of a Down's prison song is better. Prison song over jail song, exactly. Turbo Virgin Glasses. I mean, I guess if being gay makes me a Turbo Virgin, then sure. You apologize on behalf of the Jewish community for Lil Dicky. I don't know if I can accept that apology. Lil Dicky is an unforgivable crime. That's something in my hair. Oh, it's just the way my hair parts. The way my hair parts makes me look like I'm balding. I don't like it. This is why I want to get rid of the long hair. Because, like, the way it parts makes me literally look like I am balding. I'm not.
Sometimes I think I'm not either. So what do I do?
Big Richard.
Yeah.
Makes me look like I'm balding.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm just that. I'm not balding. My hair's actually growing pretty quickly. Balding reviews. Then I will just literally be another Fantano. I'll be like just. I will just be Fantano. Bass tone is fantastic on this song. Is Fantano gay? I don't think he is. I got Spottle and Fantano didn't. Exactly. Because I'm the Spottle master, and Fantano is just a Spottle commoner, okay? I am the king of Spottle. I'm unmatched. I'm actually cracked. I'm ironically cracked at Spottle. I'm so good at it. What, Travis County? You're the king of Five Nights at Freddy's, yeah? He guessed the Clash and stuff, didn't get the Cure, and I did. Just started working my way through rock bands. It's literally just guessing, it's pure luck. There is literally... Well, there's a little bit of, like, knowledge involved, I guess. But besides that, it's luck. Watch your meme. Was it in the Discord? Where can I watch said meme? Yeah, You and I in Unison is still incredible, by the way. This song I've actually returned to a couple of times since I first heard it. Actually great. The Fortnite Festival King. Yeah, Gage still can't get that 100% on I. I was watching his stream earlier and he got this close to it. He missed two notes. I'm the Spottle King. The Discord? Alright, we'll take a look in the Discord.
Because what if you go around touching kids again? But I won't, I swear.
But you might.
But I will not.
But you might.
Well, I'm just saying she looked way older than 12.
Alright, fine, Dream, but don't do it again.
I won't.
But you might.
Oh, you know me too well, don't you?
Of course I'm going to do it again. Bitch.
Wow. Jesus Christ. You got on and did it first try and laughed at him on the Yeah, I know. I looked in your Discord. Gage was unhappy about that. Worst conversation ever. Quite literally. Looks like a 9.3. Absolutely fantastic closer to this album. It's so good. It's so good. From the screaming... to the way this track insanely well builds up. That's the level of talking we are at today. Afbaf king of memes? No, Afbaf is the king of making me genuinely annoyed. What was I saying? I don't know. Song good. Album great. Let me figure out the scores. Your meme now? Hold on. We're figuring out the scores. Actually, hold on. While I do that, I'll look at your meme. Motherfucker put the meme in general, alright. Wow. What, is this it? L meme, unfortunately. Oh, Afbaf kind of meme. Oh, I thought I said Afbaf king of memes. 8.5 plus 8.7 plus 9 plus 8.3 plus 8.8 plus 9.3 plus 9 plus 8.6 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 7.7 plus 9 plus 9.3
Divide that all by 14, and you end up with a flat 9. All of your memes have the N-word hard R, so you can't send it. Alrighty then. So let me get the arm back up. Here we go. Right. I am feeling a 90 out of 100 on this album. So that's a pretty good review of this album, I think. It is in fact 17:32 in the UK right now. Wow. This album's pretty fantastic. It was pretty great. I like that album a lot. Well, I don't know why I switched to this screen. We got to figure out our next album. I'm going to go get myself a bowl of cereal before we listen to the next album, by the way, chat. I'm hungry. Okay. I'm gonna eat a bowl of cereal on stream. That's how professional we are here. What is the next album? Please, Wheel, give us something good. Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Okay. The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Man, I'm excited for this. I'm actually very excited for this. Oh my god, ladies and gentlemen, if you guys are unaware. Let me get the album up. Oh, Fantano loves this album? He more than loves this album, Crocky. He gave this album a 10! He has this as one of his classic 10s. I'm so excited for this. Okay, Brad Tace only gave it a 95, but let's be honest, Fantano's 10 matters a little bit more here. I'm very excited for this. I'm going to go get some cereal, okay? I'm going to get myself a bowl of cereal at 5:30 in the afternoon, and then we're going to listen to this album. I'll be right back. That is the wrong scene. next stream, say you'll be right back and then don't come back and come back like 3 hours later. Sure. I mean, not sure. I'm not doing that. But, like, that could be a fun idea. Didn't Brad Tasty like that exact same thing when, like, that Vultures fucking re-review stream? And the dog is barking. I may have to go downstairs and see what's wrong with him. Wait, has he stopped? Oh, he stopped. Let's go. I don't have to leave. Cool. Right, give me a sec. The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Here we go. I am very excited for this. Okay, Fantano gave this a 10. It's possible that I go back to this stream and I re-upload this. Put down dog on stream. I'm good. Doesn't seem like it would be the best idea. I'm very excited for this album. Are all the albums this long usually? The last album was like 50 minutes. This one's an hour and 17. We've had some shorter albums. They're normally like around the 40 minute mark. Yeah, I'm very excited for this. Track one, intro.
Please respond when I call your name. Kevin Chav, Jairus Boykin, Alicia Simmons, Philip Valdez, Gabrielle Salado, Victoria Bradbury, Anton Mitchell, Shaquan Sutton, Corey Thomas, Taryn Lucas, Kenia Caldwell, Tamika Marshall, Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill.
What the hell? Okay. That's nuts. Okay, intro, I guess. I guess it's setting up the story of Lauryn Hill not showing up to class. The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. She's off being a bad child, not showing up to school or whatever. Gets a question mark out of 10. I don't even know what I would score that. You're 3 question marks out of 10. Next track, Lost Ones.
It's funny how money changes situation. Miscommunication lead to complication. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young Lauryn like she done.
I'm gonna mute while I eat.
Not to game the one of the sun. Everything you did has already been done. I know all the tricks from bricks to Kingston. Kingdom, major kingdom, one wrong. Now understand El Boogie, not violent. But if a thing test me, run for me, gun. Can't take a threat to me, newborn son. El been this way since creation. A groupie call you far from temptation. Now you want ball over separation. Tarnish my image in the conversation. Who you gonna scrimmage like you the champion? You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one.
Baseline is incredible.
There's no coincidence. Hypocrites always want to play innocent. Always want to take it to the full out extent. Always want to make it seem like good intent. Never want to face it when it's
want. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just might win some, but you really lost one. You
All right, chat, I'll be right back. My mum just got in. I need to go speak to her a sec. This album, this a very good song so far, by the way. Right, I'm back. We continue. Oh yeah, this stream's 100% getting taken down with this album.
write something on the board. Let's spell it. First letter.
L. O.
What's that?
Love.
What?
Love.
How many people know any songs about love?
Well, yeah, I know a lot about
love. Tell me some titles. Titles. What's some songs?
Love.
It's a song called Love.
We making it to do up that thing with this one. Okay. I'm guessing that's going to be like a recurring... do we include the hidden tracks? Maybe. Which ones are the hidden tracks? Let me see here. Oh, the final two are the hidden tracks. Maybe. We'll see when we get to the end of the album. I'm not too sure yet. I'll probably do them. That was a very good opener. That's like... Yeah, the instrumental was insane. Lauryn Hill's vocals are absolutely incredible. The freaking production is so insanely good. That bass line in there was fantastic. And I really like the skit at the end. I'm guessing that's going to be a return thing about, like, the lessons that she's missing while she's, like, out of school or whatever. I don't know. Very good. Very good. That was incredible. Didn't like the ending, but that bass line was perfect. Yeah, that song was, Listen, maybe Fantana was cooking with that 10, okay? I don't think this is going to be a 10, but I think it's going to be like a high 9. Just based on the songs that I have heard from this, which I think might just be doo-wop. And that first song. Literally just based on those two things, I'm pretty sure this album's going to get like a 9. Next track, X Factor. Guess what? I have even more food. I have a packet of crisps. I agree, Addy. I think I might have heard this song before. But I think only maybe like once or twice. There's only like little bits of this that I'm recognizing.
Working.
Yeah, I have heard this. Probably at school. Would we still be in the Christmas half term on the 6th? I don't know. Chances are in school. Was featured on a Drake song. This bit was featured on a sampled in a Drake song. What was it? Was it Nice For What that this was set? Hold on. I mean, 3 minutes and 35 is the time stamp. I think it's Nice For What.
I want to know who motherfucking representing it here tonight.
Yeah.
Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know? Yeah.
Song's pretty good, by the way. I actually really like this song. Drake W. Where is it? We the Mid Music? Now, that Drake song's actually pretty good. I actually like that one. X Factor was written and produced by Lauryn Hill. It features elements of Can It All Be So Simple by Wu-Tang Clan, which itself samples Gladys Knight and the Pips cover of Barbra Streisand's The Way We Are. Oh, okay. I'm guessing that's... Is that this bit? They got like a whole like list of things it's taken from. So it's like from a Wu-Tang song, which samples another song, which is a cover of another song. Okay. Guitar solo is like the last thing I would expect on this. Yeah, that's... I am... Yeah. Listen. Call me a Fantano clone all you want. That was pretty amazing. That was like 5.5 minutes of like the best hip-hop ever. That... It had like a guitar solo in there. It's apparently like... What occurred to have the track one score be a question mark? It's like a little, just like a little intro piece that I couldn't really score because it was just like a teacher reading off like a register, and then it's like, oh, Lauryn Hill is not in class today. That's why track one didn't get a score. Yeah, this song was actually perfect. That was incredible. Give it a 10? I did give it a 10. This one got a 10. Is also R&B? I think so. All the genres listed.
Neo soul, contemporary R&B, East Coast hip hop, conscious hip hop, and boom bap. Yeah. Oh, the intro. I don't feel like it's fair to just say, "Oh, intro a 10 out of 10," because it's. No, it's just like a silly little intro piece to like set the tone of the album. I don't know. I'm not gonna like. I'm just gonna divide the score by 13 instead of 14 when I calculate the scores, so that the album isn't like brought down any points. And then I just won't count the intro as like having a score. It's the best silly intro piece though. I don't know. It was alright. It didn't blow me away or anything. It was cool. Next track to Zion featuring Carlos Santana.
One day, I'm gonna understand.
Okay. Ever plan on doing any Discord music listening? Yes. I wanted to do a video for, or not a video, maybe like a stream where I listen to like some albums with the Discord where we all just like hop in either, was it recording to or music listening, and then I'll just do a stream where a bunch of us listen to an album. I feel like that could be fun. Someone was asking about me listening to another Nine Inch Nails album. I responded to it. Like a really dark green that's difficult to see. Well, no, they didn't DM me. It was a comment on a video. Surprisingly, people actually do follow that rule. I don't get any DMs, which is nice. People will, like, ping me and stuff in the Discord sometimes. It's a bit annoying. But, like, I never get, like, actually DM'd, which is nice. What can you complain about now? What can you complain about? The song is very smooth. Backing vocals are incredible. Oh my god.
Yeah. How many of y'all ever been in love? But I know none of the guys been
in
love, right?
Oh, Addy, yeah.
Man right here, tell what his idea of love is. Because not all the time we hear young black men talk about love. About your personal definition. Don't tell me what Webster thinks.
Willing to do everything.
Huh?
Willing to do everything for that person.
Okay, everything like what? Explain. Let him talk, come on. If I asked him to talk about a fancy car, he'd be right on point. But we want to talk about love. You can do it. What do you think? You said you love somebody. You should know why you love them, right?
I actually really like these like skits.
That's deep, but I thought that was a beautiful point. Anybody else want to deal with that?
And sometimes, like, when they try to act funny in front of their boys and they get around and they say they love you, they can't love you. Because love wouldn't do that.
More to love than that.
Love is not funny.
Just realized I didn't add the previous song to the Tens playlist. Oh, no, never mind, I did. I'm torn between two scores right now on that song. It's not... I wouldn't give it a 10. Listen. It is this close to being a 10. It is this close. I just don't feel like it was quite on the same level as the previous song. But still, regardless, it is absolutely amazing. That song was actually incredible. Bro, that was the smoothest, most insanely well-recorded hip-hop song imaginable. The drums on that one were insane. And you get to the bit where she's talking about where it's like just all the vocals repeating march on and marching on and stuff like that. It's so good. Like, this whole portion here is like the best thing ever. That was amazing. That was so good. Next track. Oh my god. Next track. It's the song that everyone's heard. The next track, Doo-Wop.
Yo, remember back on the bully when cats used to harmonize like. Yo. Yo. My men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king, yo. It's about a thing, yo.
Feel
yo.
Real good when your hands in the air and lick two shots in the atmosphere.
Looking for your friend, the one you let hit it and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? Yeah. You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck,
censored. It's like, why is it censored?
Sleeping with the gin, now that was the sin that did Jezebel in.
Who you call Kanye sampled this, huh?
Showing off your ass cause you thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gin, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. But you still defending them now.
Why is it censored? Lauren was jailed in 2013 for 3 months because she refused to pay taxes. Wow.
Man, let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because it's sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again. Yeah. A win-win. Come again.
Based. Yeah.
Rims and his Timbs and his women, him and his men. Come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they offend, Papa Yang.
Like you got yeah.
Let's not pretend. The one that pack pissed out by the waist.
Yeah, this song is incredible.
The name of this basement, the pretty face man, claiming that they did a bit, man. Need to take.
take care of their 3 and 4 kids. Been the face in court case when the child support late. Money taking, heartbreaking, now you wonder why women hate me. The sneaky silent man, the punk domestic violence man, the quick to shoot the semen, stop acting like boys and be men. How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? Come again.
Oh, my bro. Interesting fade out. I don't actually think it's terrible. Are we going to the skit?
Hey, we got some very intelligent women in here, man. Do you think you're too young to really love?
Yeah, Addy.
No. Well, let's say it for me. If I'm an adult, I say, wait, you're too young to be in love. This is silly. You're infatuated with him. He got nice jeans. He wear fancy Adidas. I mean, it might be something I don't know. Go ahead.
Intellectual ass children here, like children nowadays vape, and that's about it. The song's pretty incredible, by the way. Yeah, that song is a 10. I have heard it before a couple of times, and yeah, I have always thought that song is amazing, and I still to this day think that that is like one of the best hip-hop songs ever. Wait, track 10, oops, I meant to put track 6. It's because I gave that song a 10 and then I was thinking 10. All kids know nowadays is vape, be non-binary, and play Fortnite. Exactly. That's all children know nowadays. Man, this album is so good so far. This album's so good. This is just so fun. It's so well produced. The writing is so sharp and so clever. Even these skits are like adding so much to like the experience of this album so far. This is amazing. This is actually incredible. And Doo-Wop is like the best example of all of that. Hot Chip and Lie. Wow. Yeah. I mean, what can I say about this? This is so good. Okay, Fantano, he was not lying when he said this album was a 10. I don't think this album's going to get a 10 from me. It's probably going to get a high 9. Next track, Superstar.
Yo, hip-hop started out in the heart, yo. Not everybody trying to charge, say what, hip-hop started out in the heart, yo. Not everybody trying to charge.
Come on now, baby, come on. So tired.
None of that, one more crap, exactly. I'm not familiar with these producers, Che Pope and Veda Nobles. Those guys produce stuff for The Weeknd, produce Ye, did another. Oh no. Yeah, he's probably like Kanye West and The Weeknd and Nas, Christina Aguilera. The Nobles. Done lots of work with Hilary Duff, Rihanna, LL Cool J, Warren G. Cool. God. So it's so romantical, yeah. The range of sounds on this is amazing. Working in so many different styles, so many different, like... I don't know. She's doing a great job of blending it. Like, she is such a great singer and such a great rapper at the same time. Her rapping and her singing are both equally as amazing. Like, it's like, everything about this is so impressive so far. She's dissing Demon Dice, yeah. What, like, when the album come out? 1998. Like, 20 years pre-Demon Dice, she was dissing Demon Dice. Hit me out. Straight up, call me Fantano clone all you want, but this is like some of the best stuff I have ever heard, ever. Like, this is
Among Us. This album is going to either get a 98 or a 100. Probably going to get a 98, maybe even a 97. Don't think it's going to get a 100. But man, everything about this is actually perfect. From the really sharp, really clever... Oh, wait, hold on. It does say Among Us. Oh, my God. Anyway, for the really sharp, really clever writing, the immaculate production, the, like... the perfect, the incredible blending of styles, the seamless blending of styles, the way it switches, the way she's able to switch from rapping to singing and make it feel so consistent and make it work so well, and the fact that both styles that she performs in work just as well as the other. This is like one of the most unique hip-hop albums I have heard, but it's also like probably going to end up being one of the best. Who's adding me? Oh, it was in Crocky's server. Next track, Final Hour. Among Us.
Written topic broken down into pieces. I introduce then produce words so profuse. It's abuse how I juice up this beat like I'm Deuce. Two people both equal like I'm Gemini. I'd rather Simeon. If I Jimmy on this lock, I can pop it. You can't stop it, drop it. Your whole crew microscopic like particles while I make international articles. And on the
Miseducation of Freddie Gibbs. That there's no way that's a thing.
I'm candid, you can't stand it. Respect demanded and get flown around the planet. Rock hard like granite or steel, people feel. Lauren Hill from Newark to Israel. And this is real, so I keep making the street ballads. While you looking for dressing to go with your tongue salad. You get the money, get the power. Keep your eyes on, keep your eyes on. Yo, you can get the money, you can get the power. Keep your eyes on, the final hour.
Apparently it's actually good as well. How did I not know about this? People actually like it. The Miseducation of Freddie Gibbs. Why does it reset the chat when I switch scenes? Like, I hate that. The Rocker by Baby version of this album next. I'm good. Freddie Gibbs haunts you from GTA 5. It's a real thing. I wish it wasn't.
Still be in the church of Lalabella singing hymns, acapella, whether pose the Marabella in couture or collecting residuals from off the score. I'm making sure I'm with the 144. I've been here before to say the battle, this is war. Word to Booney, I make a lot like a Sunni. Your diplomatic community and every ghetto community had opportunity. Went from hood shock to hood chic, but it ain't what you cop, it's about what you keep.
The writing's so good. Freddie Gibbs had like 20 songs on GTA, including features. Bam. Checking music discussion now.
Rockabye renditions of Radiohead. Lullaby renditions of Radiohead, sorry. That is terrible. Why does that exist? Yeah, that's horrendous. The user review for that. What, Rockabye versions of Radiohead? I'll look at it in a sec. That outro was a little bit long. Besides that, this song is literally perfect. It's a 9.7. Yeah, this album is... blowing me away. This album is actually blowing me away. To brainwash babies into liking Radiohead. Exactly. Yeah, this album's like the best hip-hop, the best R&B you can imagine. It's just so smooth, so clever, so sharp. Everything about this is just top-notch. Still prefer Lil Sims? Lil Sims is great. Lil Sims is incredible. So I don't blame you. But I don't, Lil Sims isn't quite at this level for me, but I do very much enjoy Lil Sims. Let's see this. Rockabye. Was it Rockabye Baby? Renditions of Radiohead. It has a 60 critic score. How to Give Your Child Depression, the album. Freaking album back up. Next track, When It Hurts So Bad. There's one for Tool. Oh my god. The band just seen live on Friday. Checked out their set list and they're playing a Karma Police cover. Is that a W or an L? Depends on if it's a good cover. If it's a good cover, then it'll be a W. If not, then unlucky. What band are you seeing? Imagine covering Radiohead. That's a Panic at the Disco moment. This is the studio version. It definitely suits Tom York's voice more. I have this spot on my head. Makes me look like I've been shot. Oh, you're seeing Pierce the Veil, yes. And if you ever been in love, then you'll understand. What you want might make you cry. What you need might pass you by. If you don't catch it, and what you need, ironically, will turn out what you want to. One for Bjork. He's got a very whiny voice, so when he sings Karma Police, it just doesn't fully work with the song's tone. I don't know, Pierce the Veil covering Karma Police is kind of wild. By the way, this is looking to be the best song on the album so far right now. Marvin Gaye, Wu-Tang Clan, they did Snoop Dogg, Red Hot Chili Peppers, David Bowie, Bjork, The Cure, The Beatles, Zeppelin, Pink Floyd, Tool, Coldplay, Metallica, and Radiohead.
an artist who's better at features than their own songs. DaBaby? Kind of. I honestly don't know. Rick Ross? French Montana, but it's just going from awful to mid. Black Eyed Peas song. That is my favorite song on the album up to this point. That was the smoothest, most like relaxing listen. That is one of the best things I might have ever heard. That was very good. That was insanely good. Nine out of ten, literally not a single skip. Yeah, this is blowing me away at how many incredible songs there. I mean, I knew I went into this knowing I would like it, but man, this is like the best. This is actually the best. They did Stan. Ronnie Radke's cover of Gangsta's Paradise. Man, the fact that that exists is upsetting.
Now I
used to love him, featuring Mary J. Blige. Need to do Falling in Reverse next. So real. The type of life that I've lived, life that I have lived. How many things I pray the Father will forgive.
One situation involved a young man.
Falling in Reverse covering Lauryn Hill. I couldn't think of anything worse. Ruining something actually good. At least Gangsta's Paradise, outside of the meme context, isn't actually that good a song. I feel like if Falling in Reverse covered this, it would actually like annoy me. Gangsta's Paradise is a good song. I just don't like it that much. I find it annoying. It's not even like the fact.
So even the fact that it's like overplayed or anything, I just think the song itself is kind of annoying. I just don't like the song that much. I don't know. No surprises and letdown kind of work as lullabies. With the guitar thing, I could kind of see it working, actually. Maybe. I need to... Let me see what other songs they have on there. You're not playing your kid No Surprises to put him to sleep? See, torn and confused, wasted in you. Reach across the road. Let's see here. No Surprises, Let Down, Subterranean Homesick Alien, Airbag, Paranoid Android, Knives Out, Karma Police, They're There, Everything in Its Right Place, 2 plus 2 equals 5, and Sail to the Moon? 2 plus 2 equals 5 as a lullaby? They're There as a lullaby? Paranoid Android as a lullaby? Huh? You don't want it to turn out like me? That is correct. If your child turns out like me, unfortunate. Imagine that, having a Radiohead fan child or a Swans fan child. At least I'm not a Weezer fan. Okay. It could be worse. Ghost and Queens of the Stone Age fan child on top. Well, I like that one Ghost album. I've not been crazy on a lot of their other stuff. But yeah, that one Ghost album, Meliora, is fantastic. And I love Queens of the Stone Age. At least not a Playboy Carti fan. Opus Eponymous is good too, but I know Lakey. Unlucky. Your parents are pretty good and they got a crunkcore enjoyer child. So maybe there's nothing you can do. Damn. Fan child. I'd rather have a Radiohead listener child than that, to be honest. That's how bad that is. I would rather have a Burzum fan child than a Maury Calliope fan child, I can't lie. Actually, no, I wouldn't. No, I wouldn't. Never mind. Man, I don't even know what to say about this. This is like just the most chill, laid-back, insanely well-produced. Like, writing is top-notch. Like, I don't know what to say about this.
it's like every single song is just as good as the last one. That's not quite a, it's like a 9.7, probably more like a 9.8. This is just like the best stuff ever. It's literally 14 tracks and 2 bonus tracks of the best hip-hop R&B crossover music ever. Mary J. Blige feature was absolutely amazing on that one too. This, I've got no complaints. I'm just gonna move on. Next track, Forgive Them Father. The music is not playing.
Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. Although them again we will never, never, never trust. Them not know what them do. They go to yai while I'm sticking like glue. Blinking green while they're plotting for you.
Let's get it pumping in this dancery, yeah. D'Angelo's on here, is he? D'Angelo is on here. $15 million monthly listeners, damn. Reminds you of Strut a little. Do I introduce the uninitiated to the song Strut in the chat? To those of you uninitiated, do I introduce you to the song Strut? Yes? Okay. Oh god, what's his name? Is it Steven? Oh yeah, Steven Seagal. I forgot Steven Seagal's name for a sec. Oh god, you guys are in for a treat. No, that's not the last song on the album. I want to remind you that the male singer in this song is this guy, Steven Seagal, known for making terrible movies and also terrible music. Why? Tell me what you really want all night. No wonder punani if I make me name. Me want the body, him want the punani. I mean the way nice. So when the girls start to strut, you could look at their butt, you shouldn't do that. The girl dress is just a pity, not just there to cover her kitty. When me and fling it up, you better know if you back it up. When me and dash it up, make sure the lyrics are wrong on this, by the way. If you ever flap it up, then me and go lock it up. Park it up like Benji who will drop. So, me want the body if you make me feel nice. Why? Tell me where you really want. That's enough of that. Let's go back to listening to The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, please. I would rather not listen to any more of the Steven Seagal song. Everything about that is wrong, yeah. Man. Forgive us our trespasses. They use your kindness as their ammunition. See, this is actually good. Shoot you down in the name of ambition. Certified Head in Hands track indeed.
Let's free the people from deception. If you're looking for the answers, then you gotta ask the questions. And when I let go, my voice echo through the ghetto. Sick of men trying to pull strings like Geppetto.
Feminism in my hip hop. Exactly. Politics in my hip hop? Exactly, there has never been political hip hop. Why are they trying to change it? Exactly. Rage Against the Machine and System of a Down, they really think they're doing something. There should not be politics in music. Is uneven. I did not see that. Get another scare at the end? Yeah. I already posted. I did not see that, Crocky. Best hip-hop albums must have the best bass lines. It's a rule of law. Yeah. You gotta have great bass lines, and you have to have incredible drums. That's what makes a good hip-hop instrumental, is how good is the bass and how good are the drums, in my opinion. This album's unmatched. This album is actually unmatched. God, it's like, you ever listen to something so good that it's like draining? Or you have to sit there and be like, man, I wish I had something bad. I wish I had something bad to say about this, but I don't. Okay? It's making me look like I'm just like a pushover reviewer who's just gonna say everything's good. Okay? Here we go, I found something I can complain about. Typo in the lyrics. Worst album ever, okay? Oh god, that was actually so good though. You put it in the Discord? Hold on, let's take a look here. Zombie Killer Gage playing Black Ops 3. My Zombie Killer Gage, Fortnite streamer, okay? Playing a different game. Right, I'm gonna wait for Groggy to post this TikTok and then we'll move on to the next track. Right, let's listen to this skit real quick.
So what she feels, what she feels is important to you.
Right.
Huh? Yeah. Why?
Because I want her to still love me. But, you know. But I know she still likes
Did the Shape of Punk to Come go on the wheel? I think it did.
Because I don't know her no more, but.
Oh, you talking about somebody. You talking
It didn't. I thought I put it on the wheel. Oh, great transition. I actually thought I put Shape of Punk to Come on the wheel. Did I not? Oh, let me read through this again. Huh, I didn't. I'm only adding that because I didn't add it before and I thought I was going to. Right.
Yeah.
That is the worst thing I have ever seen. Midtown 120 Blues. I legit only added Shape of Punk to come because I thought I already added it. I'm gonna leave the wheel as it is for now because there's 40 albums. Well, 41 albums.
I was just a little girl. Skinny legs, a press and curl. My mother always thought I'd be a star. Way before the record deal, streets that nurtured Lauryn Hill, made sure that I never go too far. Every ghetto, every city, and suburban place I've been
suspended. No.